I brought with me a good friend from the zoo. His name is Ninja. And Ninja is a year and a half old leucistic ferret. And he is leucistic because you can see that he's white. But he's not albino because albino means that he would have red eyes. Hello and welcome from the Randall Oaks Zoo in West Dundee, Illinois. My name is Kath Ellinghausen and I'm the interpretation manager here at the zoo. So my good friend Ninja the ferret here has been a friend to people for a very long time. He was domesticated about 2,500 years ago. And while he was domesticated, he helped people hunt. Oh, big yawn. He helped people hunt for rabbits and for mice. And the Romans would use them for getting pests. Now, my good friend Ninja here is a carnivore, which means that he eats meat. He cannot process any plant material through his belly. So he needs to eat, and he eats a lot. They metabolize their food very, very quickly. So he needs to eat just every few hours. But during the day, he's very sleepy. He sleeps for 18 hours a day. So 18 out of 24 hours, he is asleep. So Ninja the ferret here has a very special trick that he can do. And this very special trick that he can do is he can fall asleep on command. And when he falls asleep on command, his mama, when he was just a little guy, would scruff the little babies, the little kits, by the back of their necks, and they would be very, very quiet in case there was a predator coming. And I'll show you what happens when he gets scruffed. Ready, Ninja? We're gonna sing a song called Rockabye Ninja. Ready? Rockabye Ninja on the treetop. When I scruff your neck, the ninja will stop. Whoop, hold on, ready? Oh, big yawn. Oh, big yawn. Big yawn? Yeah. Oh, good ninja. That doesn't hurt them, but what it does is when you scruff them at the back of their neck, it releases a big dose of dopamine. And dopamine is what keeps you in the wake and sleep cycle. So just as you're falling asleep and you're in that kind of floaty, dreamy state, that's dopamine. And he just got into that floaty, dreamy state all by himself. So domesticated ferrets who've been domesticated for 2,500 years are not the same as the endangered black-footed ferret that lives out west. Black-footed ferrets are similar in that they've got long, well, they're supposed to have skinny bodies. Ninja here is rather a wide-bodied ferret, yes, but they're long, skinny animals that live in burrows. So they live in burrows underground. Do they look like they're good for climbing trees? No. Swimming? No. So when they're in danger, they dig into their burrows or they'll stand and they will even do a little bit of fighting. Orcha Ninja. When they get very excited, ferrets will do a weasel war dance, where they will jump up and down and run sideways and back up and do all sorts of wonderful weasel things. And it's not that they're angry and it's a weasel war dance, it's more that they're excited and this is an invitation that they would like to come and they would like to play. And they'll even make little sounds, they'll go dook, 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 dook. So that's called duking, D-O-O-K-I-N-G, duking, because they make a funny little sound when they are excited and ready to play. Now, ferrets look like they would make fabulous pets, and they do make fabulous pets, but they are an awful lot of work. They need to be cleaned every few hours because they have that metabolism that's so fast and they eat all the time. And you need to have them out a few times a day for at least a couple of hours in a very ferret-safe place where they can roam and play. So while they are adorable, they're good pets for older people. In order to stay entertained, Ninja needs lots of time outside of his cage. He lives in a very, very, very big house, but he needs lots of time to run around and explore. We have a cat where he lives, and he and the cat like to play together. And Ninja also needs to be enriched. His environment needs to have different toys in it, different balls that he can play with, different little puzzles that he can solve. And here at the zoo, we do a lot of animal enrichment. Enrichment is something important we do here at the zoo because it meets their mental needs as well as just feeding them and cleaning out their houses. And so we do a lot of enrichment here at the zoo to make sure that they're stimulated and they are not bored during the day. And their name in Latin means little thief. And Ferret, little thief, doesn't actually steal from us here at the zoo, but they will take things and make stashes of things. And the only thing that ninja's ever stolen is my heart.